How to rig an animate hair smoothly in Live2D Cubism. We'll be going through these three main steps. Separation. Firstly, we'll get your character's hair and cut it into many parts. If you're using Gacha Club, head to Other and then to Hide. Select Head Map and screenshot the hair. Remove the background using the selection tool in your choice of software and cut using the lasso tool or eraser. I'll cut and paste my selection for the hair, creating individual layers for each hair part. Don't forget to face and mend the layers. It is also crucial to name the hair layers or you will suffer later on. Save the file as a PSD. And you can follow this layer order. Rigging. Import the PSD by either dragging and dropping onto Live2D Cubism or by manually opening it. This is the parameter section. We'll be setting how much hair can move and such in here. Add a folder for the hair and one for the head and body. Oscillate the head position and angle parameters by holding on Shift and then by dragging it onto the head and body folder. I'll delete the parameters that we won't be using or aren't needed for this particular rig. Then let's rig the head angle Z. Select all the layers in the head folder by holding on Shift. Then use the Rotation Deformer Creation tool. Then click where the head's neck would be and pull upwards. If it's a bit off, just hold on Ctrl to adjust the deformer. But if you move without holding on Ctrl, the head will move. Name the deformer Head Angle Z. Click on Angle Z parameter and click on Add 3 keyforms. Now right click on the first keyform and rotate the deformer to the left. Right click on the left keyform and rotate the deformer to the right. You can rig the head angle X and Y as well, but for now, let's stick with angle Z. Grab your hair layers, select all of them by holding on Shift. Then click on the automatic mesh generator. I'd recommend you to pick the standard one. If there's an error and one of the hair disappeared, you can undo and select layers individually and mesh. Now let's create the parameters, but before that, we'll be using 2-3 parameters for each hair part. I usually name it hair, hair 0.5, hair 0.10. Hair moves the entire hair part. Hair 0.5 moves from the middle to the end of the hair part. Hair 0.10 moves the ends of the hair part. Let's get into action! Create 3 new parameters, name them. Select your hair layer, add a warp deformer. Then select about this much of the conversions, make sure to not select the ones at the top edge. Then add 3 keyforms, make the hair go to the left in the left keyform and rotate it slightly. Move it to the right for the keyframe at the right, rotate it slightly as well. Create another warp deformer, name it, add 3 keyforms. Then select the lower conversions to the middle and drag and rotate like the previous one. Create another warp deformer again, this time selecting conversions at the end and keyform and repeat. Note, if 3 parameters and 3 deformers are too much for you, use the last 2 middle and end ones. Head to Modeling and click on Open Physics / Blending Settings. Click on Add, then name it Hair. Select the input preset to be either the head or body. Select the Hair Triple Physics Model preset. Go to Output Settings, hit Add and select all the hair parameters before hitting OK. Make sure the pendulums are in order of 1, 2, 3. Move around the model in the canvas, then click on Increase Output. Now move around again and see the physics. Do the same thing for all the cut-up hair parts. Yes, you'll have to repeat the process of parameters and warp deformers including physics for all the other hair parts. But you can add the other hair parameters in the hair group, just make sure to fix the pendulums, order of 1, 2, 3. Head to Input Settings and here you'll see some parameters. They are the ones that the hair will react to. Add angle Y to the input settings. Add a number in the effects section. Now, if you move angle Y, the hair will also move accordingly in reaction. Although the reaction is a bit intense here, it's just an example on how it'd look. Now I'll quickly set up the other hairs. They will follow the same process, yes. I've added a few more parameters and now let's add their physics. Add them in the output setting. Then set the pendulums in the order of 1, 2, 3. If ever the physics does not look right even when you've done the parameters right, it's the physics. For any kind of layer that is attached to a big part, we'll use this. Here, I want the small hairs to be attached to this big hair. Click on this arrow twice to find the important deformers. Then you can just select and add a deformer, but it will be more complicated this way for this kind of hair, so create a warp deformer for the big hair. Then select the important little deformers. Go to Deform in the Inspector tab, then select the big hair parameter. Now the big hair will control the small hairs, while the small hairs have control over themselves. I'll rig the hair the same way as the other hairs. Here's the problem, the back hair does not attach the head during angle Z. What I'll do here is I'll add a waveform for the back hair and then I'll add keyforms and adjust it accordingly. Animation. Click on Model and change it to Animation. Drag and drop the model onto the timeline from the project. Move the head in different times in the timeline, play it to see if it made an animation. Now, go to Animation, then to Track, and select Bake Animation from Physics. Now you'll have generated hair animation from physics. Yes, this works for any length of hair. I think you'll have to improvise a bit for curly hair though. Skinning might be better for curly hair. If you have any issues or problems, please let me know. Also, this is the parameter folder order I mostly use. And yes, you can add hair Y angles too. By that, I mean hair that goes up and down instead of left and right. But I don't feel the necessity of it yet, as most of my models are one-time use once and are done in a few hours or so and don't require as much intricate work. Thank you and have a nice day.